Even though I don't make it out here very often, Kamloops is a super fun place to ride. Birthplace of free riding.
It's always nice to have Darren come up to Kamloops and ride. It's a good excuse to sort of roll out the red carpet Kamloops style and hit some jumps, go hit some high-speed trails.
A perfect day shredding in Kamloops with Hunter usually starts off with a couple laps in the bike park, finishing off with a sweet rip and single track down some mountain lines. Dropping in a line in the river, catching a few fish. Finish her off with having a couple beers, hanging out by a campfire. Here me and Hunter are. It's pretty cool to be able to look back and see all the rad things that we've both accomplished.
It seems really crazy to me that we've been on the same team for a while, because I felt like I watched Darren ride a lot longer than I've been professional, but can't even count the number of times over the years that I've seen a move in a bike film, and there's been so many that have just been so progressive and kind of like, wow, never seen anything like that before. That step down in France, single track to trail landing, that's probably one of the heaviest moves I've seen. The other way that Darren's really progressed mountain biking is by introducing a lot of new tricks to the mountain bike. I remember I was here for one shoot for Freeride, Disorder 4, and when you threed that dusty silt bluff drop, I was just like, this guy is crazy. Like, what are you doing? You can't three that. I was just standing back waiting for the dust cloud, and then you stomped it.
If it wasn't me, it would have been someone else, right?
Well, I don't know if they would have done it that soon. I don't think anyone else was ready to tee it up.
As a rider, Maddie's always been that dude that totally sticks out as a six shredder, wicked style, great humble dude, multiple wicked film segments with bitchin' moves all the way through the segments. One of the biggest ones that sticks out in my mind is actually, as of recently, did that big gap to wall ride. He got double page and bike mag, and that was pretty amazing. Guys like us were pretty fortunate to work with some of the best photographers in the world. One that sticks out in my mind would definitely be the Red Bull Illume photo of him in the trees and in the aspens. Such a striking photo, that is definitely one of those memorable all-time photos.
It's been an unbelievable experience to be in the position of being the guy that gets to go do these adventures and share them with people. I think back about the last 10 years, it's just been like a real whirlwind of change in the bike industry, and being there for it, it's been quite the ride.
Maddie and I have been on Specialized for the last 10 years, and we thought it'd be pretty cool to team up with Sterling Lorence, one of our favorite photographers, and make a cool shot as a gift, you know, like saying thanks for all the 10 great years that you've given us.
I really like the photo project and the whole process that goes into getting a photo, and Sterling and I, we've always enjoyed kicking ideas around, and it's more than a few times Kamloops has been the place we made it happen. Yeah. Yeah.
Atta boy.
To ride a line together, not something that I think anybody normally does. And that was a pretty unique feeling, like having someone in your airspace while you're riding.
Yeah, boys, you're looking good.
It was definitely a different experience, hitting a cliff at the same time.
Good job, thank you for making it happen.
All right,
we're stoked.
It'd be nice if Claw had made his arc. Close to keeper category now.
Nice cracked table there, Hunter.
That's exactly what I was thinking here. It's the dust is incredible.
You know, the sport of freeride has evolved so much in the last 10 years, and it's pretty cool for Maddie and I to sit back and realize that we've stood the test of time.